Blockchain is the topic du jour in our industry these days. The simplest way to think about it is it's sort of a different kind of database. Databases meaning a mechanism where data is sort of gathered by a system or entered into a system, and then it's available to pull out. So a blockchain is a decentralized sort of version of a database. A lot of times it's called a decentralized ledger or some sort of shared ledger. And it's encrypted in such a way that it is tamper evident, not tamper proof. So it's clear if someone has gone into it and changed some piece of data within it. So that's sort of the value that a lot of people see in blockchain, is providing a system of record across multiple parties, a lot of times that are distributed across huge geographical areas, parties that may not be able to connect with each other well, that to give them this sort of common platform, a single source of the truth that is, it's evident if anyone has tampered with the original data that was entered into it. The sort of advocates for blockchain see it as being transformational to shipping or logistics or freight movement, because it would be sort of the central repository of information across all of these parties that a shipper, for instance, works with. So a shipper is connecting to and needing data and needing to provide data to anyone from an ocean carrier to a trucking company to a warehouse to a factory to upstream suppliers to customs authorities to ports and terminals. All of these entities need to talk to each other. Drayage providers at destination, even downstream entities like their own DC and stores and customers. So if you could somehow get everybody on the same sort of, kind of piece of information that only needs to be entered one time and a copy is shared with each of those parties, that's sort of the value. Now, the problem is you don't just magically create this and have everyone adopt it. Everyone has existing databases or web portals or systems that sort of tie all these parties together today. So you're talking about needing a huge migration of all these parties to a different platform, this sort of common platform that's called immutable, which goes back to the tamper evident aspect of it. So there's a lot of relevancy to it. The question is adoption and how quickly that adoption can come, and also use cases that make sense in our industry that have a return on investment, because it is not inexpensive to build these blockchains. So in terms of where we're seeing blockchain sort of enter the scene in shipping in tangible terms, there are no shortage of companies doing pilots or projects, test projects around blockchain. I think any technology company worth their salt has at least explored whether blockchain is relevant to them, whether their customers are interested in it, and whether there's sort of a viable product offering. In terms of specific use cases, what we're seeing is things like creating an electronic bill of lading through a blockchain. We're seeing crypto tokens, which everyone is familiar with Bitcoin. Bitcoin is actually built on a blockchain. Bitcoin was the original blockchain, actually. So there are things called utility tokens, which are sort of like Bitcoin, but for a specific business purpose, that are being introduced, have been introduced, to compel behavior in the liner shipping industry. So there's one that is based around this idea of minimizing carriers overbooking and shippers no-showing with their cargo. So the idea is you have each party puts in a certain amount of these tokens, and whichever party doesn't hold up their end of the bargain forfeits their tokens, and the other party gets all the tokens. So that's one use case of a blockchain-oriented kind of project. There's a few big carriers that are piloting whether it's a possibility to do kind of an electronic bill of lading or provide this sort of single repository platform where you could house logistics documentation, things like bills of lading, shipping instructions, all the way to more customs-oriented stuff like trade compliance forms. There's probably more use cases than I can imagine right now, or that we can imagine right now, but some of the other more kind of forward-looking things are around trade finance and around providing proof of delivery when a good has been delivered to, for instance, a distribution center. So lots of interesting ideas out there. The question is, like, which of them are commercially viable at this point? The dynamics of moving freight are never get any less complicated. There's always new things, whether it's tariffs or port strikes or just general congestion or hurricanes. So those never change. In fact, they get more complex. The demands on shippers from their end customers, whether it's B2B or B2C, get, you know, more stiff every day. You know, consumers want more. They want it faster. They want it cheaper. So that, you know, kind of raises the stakes. And then the good thing is there's a ton of technology providers. Some of them software companies. Some of them 3PLs that are offering technology, that are offering cool solutions. The problem is everybody is moving their freight day to day. They're, you know, doing their day jobs. They're heavily involved in their just operations. And they don't have necessarily the time to research and think about innovation and think about what solutions they need to be adopting. So we are eager to be sort of in the mix in terms of helping them navigate where to prioritize investment, whether it's around something like a TMS, or a standalone visibility solution, or whether blockchain is you know, right for their need. There's too many solution providers for, you know, any one entity to keep track of. So if we can kind of help them navigate where they are, how to get budget for this, and then how to transition that budget into something that's really valuable for them on the investment side of things, and also something that they can, you know, projects that they can, you know, tackle in a reasonable amount of time and provide a good return on investment within a certain, you know, period. That's kind of the goal.